Matt is our next speaker. So Matt is coming from the School of Law. He was puzzled by how the government afforded the COVID pandemic spending, and he's been on a mission ever since to understand just where does the money come from. Put your hands together for Matt Crocker.
Do you remember how the Australian government spent an enormous amount of money during COVID? How overnight the government found $130 billion to spend on JobKeeper? At the time, I was halfway through my Masters of Economics, and besides all the other questions I had about COVID, I couldn't work out for the life of me how the government had found all this money. How could it be that this government, who for the last 10 years had been telling us we have to live within our means, how could it be that they had found all this money? I was left asking myself, where does the money come from? Intuitively, we all know that the Australian government makes Australian dollars, and for anyone else to do so is illegal. But at the same time, we are taught that the government needs our taxpayer dollars, and that it can only spend as much as it collects in taxes or borrows. Time and time again, we hear that they don't have money to pay our nurses more or invest in our public schools. But what I couldn't get past was the reality that when the government needed to step in as it did during COVID, the question about where will the money come from didn't even get a mention. So I asked my economics professors to explain to me how the government's finances work. They talked about budget constraints and showed me fancy equations, yet no one I spoke with could explain to me how the government spends and how it finances that spending. And herein lays the problem. The government's accounting structure and how the government actually spends remains poorly explained. But 3 years ago, I embarked on a PhD to change that. My research approach has been to describe the evolution of the laws that set out how governments in Australia have spent, from the arrival of the First Fleet in 1788 to the establishment of the Central Bank in 1912, all the way up to how the government's accounts at the RBA operate today. My research has been archival, complemented with interviews with public servants. By meticulously tracing the evolution of the legislative history and with a precise focus on describing the accounting structure, I have identified where the government's money comes from. And the truth is, the answer was staring at us all along. The government makes the money. It spends before it taxes or borrows. Now, my findings are controversial. I get that. It flips the narrative on its head. But what we thought constrains the government's capacity to spend is not a constraint at all. For the government, finding the money is never the issue. Finding the resources, the labour, the know-how, that is the challenge. So instead of asking themselves, where will the money come from, governments need to ask themselves, will this spending create inflation? My research has been picked up by the conversation in the ABC, but my hope is that it pushes policymakers, politicians, journalists to debate government spending proposals on their potential to create inflation. But if I can leave you with one thing tonight, the next time you hear somebody say the government can't afford it, remind them that the government makes the money.